हेलो गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर ज्ञान ज्योति ऑनलाइन क्लास। सो टुडे व्हाट वी गिव आवर अटेंशन ऑन द चैप्टर नंबर 3 ऑफ आवर हिस्ट्री सेक्शन एंड द चैप्टर नेम इज व्हाट नेशनलिज्म इन इंडिया। ओके, फोकस योर आईज ऑन द चैप्टर नंबर नेशनलिज्म इन इंडिया। ओके, बिफोर वी स्टार्टेड दिस चैप्टर, ओके, लेट्स टेक अ क्विक रिकॉल ऑफ आवर प्रीवियस चैप्टर। ओके, द चैप्टर नंबर 1, ओके, नॉट प्रीवियस चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 1, व्हाट द राइज ऑफ नेशनलिज्म इन यूरोप। ओके, मीन्स हाउ डिड व्हाट द फीलिंग ऑफ नेशनलिज्म, ओके, हाउ डिड द फीलिंग ऑफ नेशनलिज्म कैरेड आउट वॉट इन द हार्ट ऑफ एवरी यूरोपियन पीपल। ओके, थ्रू द आइडिया ऑफ नेशनलिज्म और यू कैन से थ्रू द फीलिंग ऑफ नेशनलिज्म मैनी यूरोपियन कंट्रीज, ओके, दे गॉट यू कैन से फ्रीडम फ्रॉम द वॉट कॉलोनियल पावर। ओके, सो वॉट दैट नेशनलिज्म फीलिंग ऑफ दैट नेशनलिज्म आइडिया फ्रॉम यूरोप, ओके, इट स्प्रेड ओवर ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड। ओके, एंड मैनी यूरोपियन सुपर पावर्स, ओके, दे सेट अप देयर कॉलोनीज इन डिफरेंट वर्ल्ड प्लेसेस इन डिफरेंट रीजन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, लाइक व्हाट ब्रिटेन ए व्हाट यूरोपियन कंट्री। ओके, एंड ब्रिटेन व्हाट सेट अप इट्स कॉलोनी और व्हाट सेट अप इट्स गवर्नमेंट इन इंडिया। ओके, सो व्हाट द नेशनलिज्म ऑफ यूरोप और द आइडिया ऑफ नेशनलिज्म इट्स व्हाट इट्स यू कैन से कैरिड आउट फ्रॉम व्हाट यूरोप एंड स्प्रेड ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड। ओके, सो यू कैन से द इफेक्ट ऑफ नेशनलिज्म, ओके, इट व्हाट गेव इंपैक्ट ऑफ इंडियन सोसाइटी ऑल्सो, गॉट इट। So what in this chapter what we'll know about what the freedom struggle of India briefly means how did what nationalism united the Indian people, okay, how did the Indian nationalist or Indian leader, okay, they were united Indian people and what started movement against the Britishers. After that, what type of you can say movement were combined by Indian people, and finally, okay, how did the Britishers were forced what by the Indians, okay, by the Indian movements, and they were what left India, and finally what we got independence in 1947, 15th August. Got it? So let's start the chapter from what the topic name nationalism. Okay? So the basic meaning of nationalism, what is love for the motherland. Indians were able to what throw out the British government from
India. Okay? So in this chapter, what the topics are, the most important topics are about Mahatma Gandhi, okay, and about, you can say, the idea of Satyagraha, okay, which was presented by Mahatma Gandhi. Then in this chapter we also discuss about what non-cooperation movement, Khilafat issue, about Rowlatt Act, okay, after that about CDM, or you can say civil disobedient movement, okay. So this type of major events were combined, what this chapter nationalism in India, you can say that what the every freedom struggle event, okay, every freedom struggle event were what combined this chapter. So what for a long period of what approximately what 200 years or above 150 years, the Britishers were what ruled over India. Okay, their strict policies, okay, their strict laws, got it? By their strict laws and policies, the Indians were faced a lot of difficulties. Okay, and you can say what unity in diversity. Okay, unity in diversity means what? The people, they were belong from different religion, caste, you can say place of birth, language, cultures, but they were united. Okay, but they were united together and they were started what? Movement against the Britishers, and you can say by the efforts. Okay, by the sacrifices of our ancestors, now what we are standing here. Okay, we got the freedom. Now what you can say, we have every what rights to deliver our speech, to move outside. Okay, to what, where, what you can say, what you want, you can work. Okay, what you want, you can take food. Got it? So what, by the sacrifices of our ancestor, our freedom struggler, okay, now we are able to what stand here, what you can say free, move anywhere free. Got it? So the story was begin what the story was begin through our father of nation, what, Mahatma Gandhi. What before Mahatma Gandhi, okay, many political leaders, many freedom, you can say struggle, they were fought, you can say fought against the Britishers, okay, but what the impact of words of Mahatma Gandhi, the efforts of Mahatma Gandhi, okay, made him the father of nation, the father of what? India. Got it? What? The efforts of Mahatma Gandhi towards our freedom movement. Okay? Consider himself as the what? Father of our nation. So let's discuss about what you can say the efforts of Mahatma Gandhi towards our freedom movement. Okay, so the Mahatma Gandhi returned to India in 1950. As we have already know about Mahatma Gandhi, that Mahatma Gandhi, okay, you can say travel what South Africa for his what barrister degree. Got it? After that, Mahatma Gandhi returned to India in when 1950, and he, you can say, took part in the what struggle of what the Indians, took part in the, you can say, yeah, struggle life of the Indians. From South Africa, Gandhiji's novel method of mass what agitation is known as satyagraha. Satyagraha emphasized truth. Okay, so Gandhiji, you can say, had already what combined the mass agitation in what South Africa. Got it? Because in South Africa there was what the apartheid system was, you can say, create a lot of differences between the white people and what the black people. Got it? So in this you can say color matter or creed matter, what Gandhiji supported the black people and combined a mass agitation or mass movement against the what white people in South Africa. After he returned to what India, and he what joined in the struggle life of the Indians. Okay, Gandhiji what also started what many movements against the Britishers, because he, you can say, he had the experience of what combined mass movement against the repressive, or you can say against the harsh ruler. Okay, that's why what Mahatma Gandhi launched the idea of satyagraha. What the idea of satyagraha? Idea of satyagraha, okay, and it emphasized the truth. Okay, emphasized the truth, or you can say fact. So Gandhiji always thought about what or follow the way of idea of satyagraha. That's why he launched what the satyagraha movement. Okay, we what based on what you can say truth and what non-violence activities. Okay, truth and non-violence activities. Okay, then Gandhiji believed that if the cause is true, okay, if the struggle is against injustice, then physical force was not necessary to fight the oppressor. A satyagrahi can win the battle through non-violence. Okay, a satyagrahi can win the what movement, you can say, to follow up the non-violence activity. If what he or she, or if the group, okay, if they are what fought against injustice. Got it? So people including oppressor had to be persuaded to see the truth. Truth was bound to ultimately triumph. Got it? So that's why what Gandhiji followed the idea of satyagraha. In India, okay, the first was at Champaran in 1916 to inspire plantation workers to struggle against oppressive plantation struggle against. Okay, oppressive plantation system in 1917, satyagrahi at Kheda to support peasants. Okay, and also in 1918, satyagraha at Ahmedabad. Means what? Gandhiji rapidly combined what three satyagraha movement in 1916 at Bihar, Champaran. Champaran in Bihar,
okay, with the support, you can say with the support of, in support of the farmers, okay, and in Kheda, the plantation workers, okay, and in Ahmedabad, in the support of cotton mill workers, okay. So you can say these were the beginning of Satyagraha movement in India by Mahatma. Okay, then about Hind Swaraj, the famous book written by Mahatma Gandhi, which emphasized non-cooperation to British rule India. Yes, Mahatma Gandhi also wrote a book named what, Hind Swaraj. Okay, where he, you can say, he was put the idea of Satyagraha or non-cooperation against the British. So in the beginning period, okay, of Mahatma Gandhi, he what, laid the free Satyagraha movement in 1916, in 1917, and in 1918. Okay. Okay. So this were the early event, or early you can see Satyagraha movement led by Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, let's move up to our next important topics. Okay, the impact of First World War, you can say First World War, First World War. Okay, then Khilafat issue, and third, non-cooperation. Okay, what, the First World War, or you can say the impact of First World War on India, then what was Khilafat issue, and why did Gandhi ji launched non-cooperation movement against the Britishers. Okay, so when what, Mahatma Gandhi led free Satyagraha movement in India, it was also the period of First World War. Okay, 1914 to 18. It was the period of First World War also. Okay, so what, Britain directly involved in the First World War, and the Britishers, they were ruled over India. That's why, okay, the effect of what, First World War, okay, it also failed by the Indians or Indian economy. Okay, so during the World War, or during, you can say, World period, the Indians were suffering a lot, okay, by the policy of the Britishers. Got it? You can say by the revenue, or through the revenue, what, the Britishers, they fulfilled their military expenditure. After that, what, during World War, what, the British government, what, increased the war, or increased what, military expenditure. That's why the Indians were what, forced to pay what, you can say, more revenue. Okay, after that, what, the food prices were also increased by British government. Okay, and what, forced recruitment were, you can say, formed by what, British ruler in rural areas. Forced recruitment means what, the young masses of Indian society, basically in rural area and village area, they were forced by the Britishers to join in the British army. Okay, and what, you can say, fought in First World War. Okay, this was known as what, forced recruitment.
So this type of difficulties were faced by what Indian people what during First World War. Got it? That's why what in 1909. Okay, remember this. Okay, in 1990, the Indian leaders, okay, with the masses, okay, they were involved in many political activity against the British government. Okay, against the British government during war period. That's why British government passed an act named what passed Rowlatt Act. Act in 1990 to repress every type of political activities in India. Okay? And through the Rowlatt Act, the Britishers can what? Imprison a political leader of India without any trial. Okay? Without any trial or court, you can say, Marshall, the Britishers were forced the Indian political leaders into jail, into prison. Okay? Through Rowlatt Act, which was passed by British government in 1909. Got it? So, through the Rowlatt Act, many political leaders of India, they were what? Arrested by British government and put into the jail. Got it? On 13th April, remember this day, on 13th April 1919, okay? On 13th April 1919, a huge crowd gathered in the enclosed grounds of Jallianwala Bagh. Okay? Against Rowlatt Act, okay? The masses, the Indian people, okay? They were gathered in a garden of Punjab in Amritsar, okay? The Jallianwala Bagh. Got it? And here the Jallianwala Bagh incident, or you can say the Jallianwala Bagh massacre happened. So on 13th April, okay, against Rowlatt Act, got it? The masses, they were gathered in Jallianwala Bagh, okay? General Dyer, you can say by the British government to repress what? The activity of that masses. General Dyer sent by what? British government to repress that activity in Jallianwala Bagh. General Dyer entered the area, blocked the exit points and opened fire on the crowd and killing hundreds of people. Got it? So, remember this thing that on 13th April 1919 against Rowlatt Act, okay, many people, they were gathered in Jallianwala Bagh, okay, in Amritsar, Punjab state, got it, 13th April 1909, okay, and you can say to repress that activity, British government, what, sent General Dyer, a military general, okay, he entered to the place and you can say closed every exit gate of that garden and what ordered to his soldier to open fire to them. Got it? And that case you can say is known as Jallianwala Bagh massacre or incident. So in that event, in that you can say what incident, many Indians killed brutally by the British soldiers. Okay? And rapidly the news of mass killing was spread all over India and the, you can say and the Indians, okay, and the mean you can say Indian masses, okay, they were showed their aggression against the British government when the mass killing news was spread over all in spread over India. Got it? After that, what Khilafat issue? Khilafat issue. What was Khilafat issue? Got it? So the First World War end with the what? End with the defeat of Ottoman Turk. Ottoman Turk. Got it? So the British government, what you can say, passed an agreement or act to reduce the power of what you can say the ruler of Turk. And the ruler of Turkey, he was known as the religious head of the Muslim, and he was known as Khalifa. That's why what the Indian Muslim people, okay, to protect the power of what Khalifa, the Indian Muslim people, they were wanted to what started a movement against the Britishers to protect the power of their religious head. Okay, two Muslim leader, Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali, okay, or you can say two Ali brothers, okay, they were what combined a you can say Muslim committee, okay, or Khilafat committee, okay, to protect the power of Khalifa. And what during this period, what in 1900 and you can say yes, in 1920, okay, in 1920 the Congress session of Nagpur, Congress session of Nagpur, okay, the you can say the idea of non-cooperation movement what took by Mahatma. Okay, listen one more thing. After Khilafat issue was raised by the Muslim, Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali discussed with Mahatma Gandhi. And Mahatma Gandhi always thought about the, you can say, thought about the unity of Hindu and Muslim people. That's why what Mahatma Gandhi, what you can say, didn't let, you can say, didn't left the what choice, didn't left the, you can say, idea of non-cooperation movement, and he thought that it was a golden opportunity to united both and Muslim people. Okay, that's why Mahatma Gandhi was also what helped the Muslim people and ready to launch a movement against the British. Got it? So what in the Nagpur session of Congress in 1920, okay, what it was decided to what launch a mass movement against the British. Okay, and finally what in 1921, okay, the non-cooperation movement was launched by the Indians against what the British power. Got it? So you can say that the non-cooperation movement, okay, which was led by what Mahatma Gandhi, under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi, you can say non-cooperation movement also what Khilafat movement, because by the Khilafat issue, okay, with the support of Muslims people, okay, महात्मा गांधी और लॉन्च नॉन कॉपरेशन मूवमेंट इन 1921 अगेंस्ट ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट. ओके सो इन आवर नेक्स्ट क्लास विल डिस्कस ओके व्हाट टाइप ऑफ पीपल ओके और मीन्स विच क्लास ऑफ पीपल दे वर व्हाट एक्टिवली पार्टिसिपेटेड इन नॉन कॉपरेशन मूवमेंट like peasants, business class people, okay? You can say after the educated young masses of India, women, okay? Every class people, okay? Why did or how did they were joined in non-cooperation movement and what was the condition of non-cooperation movement in rural areas and in urban areas, in countryside, in village areas and in cities and town, what was the condition of non-cooperation movement, how did the town, you can say, the people who have lived in town and the villagers, they were played, what, their role in non-cooperation movement and about what CDM also or civil disobedient movement also. And what type of steps were, what taken by the government, are taken by the British government to repress the, you can say, the repress the freedom struggle of India, okay, which was, you can say, led by our great and famous political leaders, or different leaders. Okay, so this is all about today's class. Thank you. Have a nice day.